The federal government remains shut down for one reason and one reason only, because Democrats will not fund border security.
President Trump says the border wall is a matter of national security. He's calling Congress to step up and spend billions for the wall.
But as our Washington correspondent Mark Meredith explains, Democrats say the president is creating chaos to win political points.
In a primetime address, President Trump reached out directly to the American public to make his case that the U.S. needs to build a border wall. But the president is facing an uphill battle with Democrats on Capitol Hill who say the wall is a waste of time and money.
This is a humanitarian crisis, a crisis of the heart, and a crisis of the soul.
In an Oval Office address, President Trump told Americans why he's demanding that taxpayers pay for a border wall.
This barrier is absolutely critical to border security. It's also what our professionals at the border want and need.
The president says $5.7 billion for the wall is cheaper than the cost of illegal immigration. He says that securing the border with a steel barrier is vital to U.S. national security. It's the argument that has led to a nearly three-week-long partial government shutdown.
But the only solution is for Democrats to pass a spending bill that defends our borders and reopens the government. This situation could be solved in a 45-minute meeting.
Right now, 800,000 government employees, from TSA agents to park rangers, are either furloughed or working without pay. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi says those employees and the public deserve better.
The fact is, President Trump has chosen to hold hostage critical services for the health, safety, and well-being of the American people.
Democrats are pushing the president to reopen the government now and then debate border wall funding in February.
We don't govern by temper tantrum, so our suggestion is a simple one. Mr. President, reopen the government and we can work to resolve our differences over border security.
The president plans to meet with congressional leaders for a third time on Wednesday before heading to Texas on Thursday to tour the U.S.-Mexico border.
The president will also sit down with Senate Republicans on Capitol Hill on Wednesday. So far, a small number of GOP lawmakers have said they'd like to see the government reopened now, even if the fight for border security remains unsolved. Reporting in Washington, I'm Mark Meredith.
Senator Tom Tillis released a statement shortly after the president's address. He says Congress must be willing to compromise to end the gridlock and produce a positive outcome for the country. We also heard from Representative Mark Meadows.
Hopefully, Democrats and Republicans can come together and find some common ground. You know, a little give and take. I think that's what the American people want us to do.